Hi, Maria the Amateur Crafter here. I am making a Christmas tree today. It's from Millipede Lane Inspired. I subscribe to her so I get all of her designs for free, but I'll go ahead and show you how to do that and get this design. It's a 3D Christmas tree and we're going to do it from start to finish. So this may be a longer video. Feel free to fast forward, even though you'll miss my amazing commentary. So first of all, let's look here at Melody Lane Inspired. We're going to go to her supporter projects. Let me put in the code. Sure, I'm going to update that password. And this is actually one of her new projects, so I'm just going to go to the new section. This 3D Christmas tree. So when you click open, that will actually open Design Space. Well, it will bring you to this page, and now I'm going to open Design Space. And Design Space opened, but you cannot see it, so let me bring it. I have two instances open. So let me minimize that one and open the other instance. Oh, I wonder if it's on a different monitor again. Let's see. I thought I fixed this last time. No, I should see that there. It must be minimized. So let me close the window and quit and try Melody Lane Inspired again. So close that. Open. And I should just be able to click open again. I probably don't even have to check that box. There we go. Now Cricut is opening, or Design Space is opening. There we go. Going to get rid of my browser. And I am going to edit a copy so that it puts it in my personal files, but I'm not going to share it with her, with anybody, because it's Melody's intellectual property, so I don't want to share that out. Okay, so there's two things that I'm going to do. I want my tree to have snow on it, so I am going to copy all of this. Let me move that star. I'm going to duplicate all of this stuff. Move it over. And I'm going to set all of its color to white because I want snow. So, there we go. So half of my stuff is snow and the other half is red and green of different colors. Okay, let me save this project so it's in my projects. And then let me go to make it. I think that should be correct. I'm actually going to get out a scrap piece of yellow for the star tops. Ooh, although I don't have any gold paper. I guess I better not do gold paper. So let me get out some scrap yellow. Get two. Depending on how big it is. I have a Maker 3, so it's asking me if I want to work on the mat or not, and I do want to work on the mat. And it looks like I can do this with, it's saying that for these I need different mats, but I'm going to move the snowflakes around a little bit. I don't know if they're snowflakes. The trees around a little bit to see if I can get some, make some room and use less paper. Actually, you know what? I think this one will fit up here better. And let's see. No, that's not gonna fit. But if I move that over, I can fit all three of those there. Now let's take a look at the next mat. This is like playing a game, a puzzle game. You can probably put that over. Let's move this to the previous mat. Move object to the first mat. Do I have any mats? Nope. I don't have anything that's overlapping. Let's see if I can fit one of these others. Let me do the next smallest one. And let's try one more. I only bought three paper pages of the snow paper. I've got to make it fit with three. That's just what I've got to do. Okay, so those aren't overlapping and they're close. Okay, so let's see. There's actually quite a few more pages, but let's see if we can move this. Move object, put it to the previous page. But I wonder if I rotate this, if it's gonna... I'm holding the shift key so that it will rotate on 30, 60, 90s. I don't think that helped any. 30, 60, 90, 45s. Okay, let's move that back. I don't think that helped any. Oh, nope. That wasn't it. There we go. But we should be able to fit this one down here. And let's see if we can fit this one on the page after. There we go. Okay, so I fit the white on three mats, it looks like. Please be no more white mats. Oh, there's two more white mats. Let's see if we can squish them up a little bit. We'll move this to the previous one. Let's put this on mat three. See what I can do. Let's put this one on mat four. Move this one. Mat 3, 2. Okay, so that fits. Now let's see if I can move this one to mat 4. Okay, that is super close. So let's move this guy down and over. I don't know if that's going to make a difference. You know what? The other thing that I can do is just hide one of my, the biggest snowflake, and just not put it on the bottom row. So I will do that. And, goes on 2. So I just won't. See if I can use better usage of paper here at least. Okay. I can still use that upper right hand corner. Okay, so I did that. Now let's look at the stars. The stars can go on a 4-inch piece and by 1.5 inches. So I've got a piece of yellow that will fit those. Now we're gonna have to move the mats again. And you know what I think I may do? Is just get rid of the biggest star. So this one's the 7-inch one, since I got rid of it on the other mat. So we'll just hide the biggest I want to unhide that. So to unhide it, I come down here to hidden and I select bring it back. So it looks like I thought I was supposed to have 3 sheets of each, but it looks like I have 3. This is weird. Oh, okay. There's two mats of the light green and then 3 mats of the dark green. Okay, that's what's going on. So let's see if I can get these onto 2 mats, the dark green. I think I can. Excuse me. Chew, bless me. Excuse me. So let's move this guy just to the mat above. And here he is, and there he fits. Okay, good. So we'll need 2 pages of dark paper and 2 pages of light green. Of dark green and 2 pages of light green. So we're going to continue that. And let me grab my paper. Two sheets of dark green, and these are 12 by 12 sheets. 2 of dark green, and we are using medium cardstock. My blade is dull, so I'm going to select more pressure, and we should be good. And actually, do you know what I'm going to do is I'm going to click back on this top one and start with the white, and I'm not going to select medium cardstock for the glitter cardstock. I'm actually going to go search for glitter cardstock. Because it needs different settings. Okay, I'm gonna have to test it. So we're gonna start with this glitter cardstock. And again, I'm gonna do more pressure because I know that my blade is is worn out a little. Okay, so that is all correct there. Let's switch over to my desk camera so that you can see the glitter cardstock. There we go. It's more of like an iridescent. It's supposed to look like snow. That's the goal. Okay, so this isn't exactly 12 inches by 12 inches, so I'm going to try and center it as best I can so that it will not cut on the edges. I'm going to grab my brayer as well and push it down. This is an old mat that I'm making work. There we go. That looks a lot better. Okay, and my machine is blinking. Oops, sorry about that. I don't know how that happened, I'm sorry. I thought that I had that correct, so excuse me. So my machine's asking me to load my paper. And Cricut Design says, Space says it's measuring the mat length. Loaded fine point blade, and it's ready to go. So let's watch and see what happens. Uh-oh. I noticed an error on my mat placement for one of these snowflakes, so there'll be another branch that doesn't have snow on it. Oh, well. Life goes on. I want to test the cut already, but I know that's too early, so. While that's going, I'm going to grab the other parts of this project. We do have to create some items to fit the base, and I haven't done that yet, so let me do that too. I think I'm going to use my shimmer paper for that, so let me get that out as well. My brown shimmer paper. There it is. There's a light brown. Oh, and the red. That other one's like a Merlot color. That will be after. So, I'm going to see if I can Yeah, that looks like it cut all the way through, even on those tiny little cuts. Thank you. Well, while that's cutting, let me show you the other pieces that I bought. So I did buy this foam, floral foam piece for the base of the Christmas tree. I didn't need to buy this. I got home and realized, duh, I could have just cut it out of chipboard. I've got plenty of chipboard or craft board, and I could have just used that instead. So, oh well. But, so I'm going to use this piece. It's just, I'm going to cover it with this shimmer, brown shimmer. I guess maybe it's a copper color. So I'll have to cut a 3-inch circle and then a rectangle that will go around the edge to cover that up. And we'll have to glue that with hot glue gun. So maybe I should get out the hot glue gun. I'm going to need it. There we go. And then these are just to separate the branches from each other. So just cute little beads. I'm going to do a mix and match. Use various ones. I don't think I'm going to keep them in any particular order. And now the center of the tree, I am actually just going to use bamboo skewers. And I have them here in my stash, in my drawers. And for the life of me, I can't seem to find them right now. Oh, that's because I think I put them somewhere else. Nope, I didn't. But I know they're here, so I'll keep looking. Here's my chipboard. Oh, there they are. There we go. Yay! So I'm just going to poke that down in the tree and make it work. So I may skip the branches that I messed up on the snow with. I don't know. Now that we'll wait until it's done cutting and then I'll decide what to do. Who knows? You know what, while that's going, I'm going to go ahead and set up another mat just so that I have two mats going at the same time. I can weed one while one is cutting, essentially. And of course, this is the mat that's going to take the longest because it has the most pieces. You can see it cut on the other side, and those two in the upper right that I messed up. almost done. Oh, glitter cardstock cuts twice. There's glitter all over my machine. That cut really well. So I should tell you about Melody Lane. She designs with free accesses or access images. So if you're an access subscriber, then you can use her designs. Or if you're not an access subscriber, then you can, you know, pay the little extra that Cricut charges for. So pay the extra that Cricut charges for her designs. I've used maybe a handful of her designs, so I'm not sure if it's worth it, but it's pretty cheap. It's only $2 a month, so I don't feel like I'm spending a lot of money supporting her. And I do watch her YouTube channel, so... You know, it's nice to support a creator when you can. Especially if you're getting value from them. Okay, this is all ready. Oops, I want to do... You know what? I'm not going to do more pressure on this one because it seemed to cut really well. Get that started. Oh, I have enough to recut those snowflakes that I messed up on, so. That's good. Let's go ahead and get these snowflakes off the mat. I keep calling them snowflakes, but they're tree branches. So we pull the mat away from our paper. And then there's the messed up one up there. So we'll get to that in just a second. Here's one that didn't come off. He's tiny. And here's the one that got messed up. So that's in the upper right-hand corner. We'll have to remember that. So I can pull those apart and recut them. Just scraping off the extra. Into the trash can. While I've got this here, I'll get the next mat ready. My brayer's all covered in glitter now. Everything's going to be covered in glitter pretty soon. That's the way it goes. So that's the other one that I messed up. And that one was so close, but tiny little error there. You can't even see it on the camera. That means I am not going to worry about it in real life. I wasn't going to worry about it anyways, but but now we know for sure. Okay, I'm actually going to start putting these in size order. Because I'll need them in size order for later. Okay, and I do have some extra pieces here. I'm not sure if any branches will be able to fit in those ones, but I will set this aside in case I need it. Oh, there's one more. Let's see if he's smaller or bigger than that smallest one. Smaller. There is glitter everywhere now. Oh, these bamboo skewers, I just got them. They're the ones that you sell at the grocery store. Nothing special about them. Almost done. And let's put in our last mat. Oh, it's not asking me to load it yet because it wants me to select some things in Design Space. Oh, it looks like I messed up another set of snowflakes. Oh, no, I didn't. I thought I did for a second. Okay. So, I need to select glitter again. This is glitter cardstock. Whoops, we cut that mat already. We're on mat 3 now. Good thing I noticed. Glitter cardstock. Okay. Now the Cricut machine is asking for stuff. Okay. Just a little bit this time. Move this mat away. These are going everywhere. Oh, that didn't cut exactly right. So I'm actually just gonna crease the paper, and then usually it just pops right off where it's been scored. There we go. So I actually have quite a bit of paper on this one that I can fix some of those small ones that I messed up. Okay. Oh, whoops. I just knocked off my Let's Get Crafty sign. That's just fine. Okay. Let's see what the... I'm gonna have glitter everywhere for weeks. You know what might have been easier? It's just to get some of that glitter spray and spray the tree after, because that looks really nice. Oh well, next time. Uh-oh, this piece of green isn't going to work. Let me go get another one. I don't remember if the light green or dark green was next, so I'll wait there. But I do see that the yellow is next, so I'll put the yellow on. And it looks like I might be able to use this much. I'll have to check on the size of the stars just to be sure. Go back to the Cricut and see how it's doing. So it looks like this is just under 1.5, so I'm going to have plenty of room with how I've placed my, So here in design space, my stars are only going to take up about 4 inches wide and 1.5 inches down at the most. That leaves some space on all of the sides. So the paper, how I have it on my mat, is going to work just fine. Okay, so back to design space. It's medium cardstock. This one I am going to select more on, just to cut out those stars. Cricut. Lots of room on this one as well. Those are done already. Set this aside. Look at the Cricut. Yeah, those did just fine. Back to the desk. And I'm actually bending my mat so that I don't bend the stars. There we go. Okay, I have my two mats now. Let's see, are we doing light green or dark green next? We are doing light green first and then dark green. So medium cardstock, more. I'm going to select, medium cardstock, I'm going to select more on my pressure. That is ready. We need the light green cardstock this time. Oops, I just dropped my... Okay. And this is just ready for the Cricut. And I'm going to prepare my next mat while I'm waiting. So let me show you how I save paper. I don't know if we have to save paper. I'm still at a loss, but I'm just going to cut off the parts that are so small that I probably am not going to use them. And then I'm just going to put this piece in my stash, and this goes in recycling or trash. So let me go put my two yellow pieces away. My camera is bugging me that it wasn't square. I'm sure it'll move in a little bit. You know what? While that's cutting, let's go ahead and get these all back in order again. Looks like I just missed these three sizes. That's the next size. So we'll go back and see if I have enough room for the white one. The big white, the biggest white one. I think I can fit on this piece with a little bit of creativeness, which means I probably could have fit it on while cutting, but I didn't. So that's two pieces, three snowflakes, branches to fix. Well, let me show you what I mean. Okay, so the biggest snowflake. Whoops, my Cricut's done. Oh, I got a little bit of a snag there. Uh-oh. Show you what I mean. There's a little bit of a snag right there. Well, darn it. It might have been the glitter. The Cricut is asking me again. It did not remember. Maybe I didn't check it. So remember material settings. Now back over to the Cricut itself. Get this loaded. So this is the largest snow. Oops, I'm on the wrong camera. This is the largest snowflake, and I know that if I position this carefully, I can see a little bit of it coming through, but I think that's going to be just fine because some green is going to show through on the branches, and it, you know, if the a couple of the tips are cut off on the branch, I think it's going to be just fine. I'm not too worried about it. And then I'll use this base for the other two small ones. Unless, challenge, I can fit it on here, which I don't think I can. Actually, I should have kept those two. Let me grab them. See where I can fit them. No. So this piece is done. Trash. None of those pieces are big enough that I'm going to save it for anything. I'll just go buy more paper. These two will easily fit on, you know, on here. So no problem there. These are the two, and then we'll cut the big one on the other. Oh, I haven't unloaded these yet. and it's done because I wasn't paying attention. I think that's it. Let me scrape this off and get it ready for my next mat. So this side has a textured side and a non-textured side. It doesn't really matter which way is up. It matters if I care which way I want the textured surface, but it doesn't really matter. You probably can't even see that on the camera, but I'll show you here in just a sec. Okay, so here's the plain side. And here's the textured side. You can kind of see it a little bit there. Okay, over to the Cricut. Pop that out. Over to Design Space. It remembered my settings this time. Excellent. So back to my Cricut. Oops, that didn't load properly. It's all skiwampus here on this side. Ooh, it sounds so bad. I'm going to have to reload that. So let me just press the buttons here. And try again. Yeah, that was much better. Ooh. Okay. Now let's... Well, that's cutting. I've made a mess here. Let's pop out these ones. Oh, so that snagged. So it looks like I'm going to have to use some scissors to clean this one up. Scissors. Here they are. So it didn't. So I'm gonna eyeball this. It's a little bit skewampus. You know what? You can't even tell in the camera. And with all of the other branches, once they're done, you won't be able to tell at all. So let me see if I can clean it up a little bit at all. This is probably where I should get my true control knife, and there we go. I kind of cleaned it up a little bit better. Okay, so snowflakes. There's the green, the light green, part of the light green. There's a few pieces of this that I might want to save. And I could have really done a better job of placing those. So I guess just this green piece, and this is too small. I'm not going to use that. You got to make rules for yourself. I heard one lady said any credit card size piece she would keep, but anything smaller she'd let go. And I think that's probably useful. You have to keep a quarter of an inch on each side. So you need at least, you know, half an inch square. And then plus the size of what you're cutting. So, you know, 2 inches, 3 inches. Okay, let's do the clean up the other. Got some snags on the other one as well. I should have thought about it a little bit more. Maybe done the textured side down. So here's a nice piece of paper that we can keep. Just gonna cut this right off. Gonna put the green piece away. You know what? This is really snagging so much that I might want to cut this green mat again. I'm gonna check my blade and see if it's really dirty. And it is. I'm gonna try and clean it off and see if that helps. I should have done that with the first snag. And you know what? I don't think, yeah. I didn't drop it well enough.